They have been led a primitive life, and thereafter, one by one, necessities arose, and based on that, we have tried to improve our standard of living by adopting facilities or creating facilities which would enable us to lead a better life. As far as the greatest innovator, in order to do that, we have to make innovations. And the greatest innovator is the nature himself. If you look at the nature, a number of inventions have taken place on behalf of the nature. You look at the life forms which are present, the diversified forms of life. Then we also see the diversified forms of plants, and so also materials. We have different types of sand, rocks, then timber, etc. All these are provided by nature. So nature has invented all those things. In addition to that, certain devices or contrivances are also created or innovated by the nature. A lever, for instance, we very often use in a technological term, first order lever, second order lever, etc. But lever as such is created or innovated by nature. Wheel, a spear, many fruits have the resemblance of a spear. Similarly, the log of a tree, that resembles a cylinder. And then between the hillocks, the nature has created dams. Shelter has been provided. Earlier, the primitive men, they lived in caves. And they also wore cloth or made of leaves. And again, you look at the ball and socket joint. A ball and socket joint is there in the body of human beings, and so also the animals, etc., birds, etc. Cantilever beams. If you analyze a tree, you can see that some of the branches are acting like a cantilever beam. And therefore, innovation skills were developed in man by learning it from the nature himself, nature itself. And that was so much earlier, and now it continues to do so even now. Why it happens? And this innovative talents are existing only in the case of man, not in the other life forms. A man, because man is more intelligent, and man is possessed with the ability to make inventions or innovations. How this is taking place? Because through, that is happening through man's activities resulting from observations. He has the ability to observe. He has the ability to do experimentations. He is able to do logical thinking and make judgments. He is able to organize results under general principles. And he is also able to apply these principles and also manipulate many activities. And this may be occurring either alone or in combination of one or more of them. Man's said activities lead to changing facilities available to human race. This change may be mostly for betterment. I don't exclude those which may be detrimental as well, but any change that we bring about as based on the activities of man, it is mostly for betterment. This change has been vast and enormous, and it is now taking place at a rapid pace. In the primitive days or in the stone ages, etc., the change took place at a very slow pace. But now, as facilities are getting improved, it is leading to a change with a rapid pace. And the ultimate result is improving the standard of living of human beings. When are we required to make an invention? And that is when there is a necessity. There is a great English proverb which says, necessity is the mother of invention, meaning that difficult or impossible scenarios prompt inventions aimed at reducing the difficulty. So it is difficult or impossible situations which prompt inventions, and that is intended for reducing the difficulty associated with that. If you look at the different dictionaries, which defines the proverb as, when the need for something becomes imperative, you are forced to find ways of getting or achieving it. That is according to the Oxford Dictionary. Cambridge Dictionary says, if someone really needs to do something, she or he will think of a way of doing it. Longman is almost in line with the Cambridge Dictionary. When we are associated with innovations, three words or three terminologies come to our mind. One, innovate, invent, and discover. To outline what innovation is, to innovate means to start or introduce something new, or to modernize or change, or to renew or alter. Invent, it is to create or devise something new or original. So there is hardly any difference between innovate and invent. Because if you look at it, we are trying to bring in something new or something original. It could even be a modernization or changing or renewing or altering it through innovations. And the last one is discover, to find or learn about for the first time. So that is something which is already existing. We are not making or attempting or resorting to any inventive step or innovative step. But all that you are doing is you are simply unearthing anything that is existing and bringing it into limelight. Invention, according to Cambridge Advanced Learner's Dictionary, it is something that has never been made before, or that means when you are making an invention, that device is something that has never been made before, or a process of creating, it could even be the process of creating something that has never been made before. For example, the world changed rapidly after the invention of the phone, a most amazing invention. So the first invention that is underlined there, the word invention, which is underlined, it refers to the process of creating, so after the invention of, and the last one, which is underlined, that refers to the article. So one is the process of doing the invention, and the last one refers to the article that has been created. And the Oxford Dictionary defines invention as something, typically a process or a device. So it could be a process or a device that has been invented, and invent means create or design something that has not existed before. To take an example, medieval inventions included spectacles for reading and the spinning wheel. Innovation, as defined by the Cambridge Advanced Learner's Dictionary, the use of a new idea or a method. It could be a new idea or a method. It could also be the use of a new idea or a method. For example, the latest innovations in computer technology. Looking at innovation from the point of view of the Oxford Dictionary, it means a new method, idea, product, etc. Cite an example, technological innovations designed to save energy. A number of innovations have taken place to save energy. Now looking at innovation, three things have to happen if an innovation has to take place. One, there has to be an idea. Not only that you have an idea, you have to make it work. That means you have to make some effort to ensure that the idea that you have in mind is put to work. And then, not only that, maybe that if you have an idea and you have made it work, maybe for your own purpose. But that should not be the case. should be made to be liked by people. So one requirement is make it liked by the people, because we are being sustained by the efforts of others. Similarly, we also have a commitment to serve the society as well. So in order to serve the society, we have whatever innovation that we are making as a result of the idea and the work associated with that, we have to ensure that the article or the innovation that has been made should be made liked by the people. Very often we go in for patents. India in 1970 enacted its first patent act. So according to the Patent Act, that is 1970 of India, invention means any new and useful. So you look at the two terms there, new, and in addition to that, useful. So it has to be something new and it has to be something useful. So it could be an art, it could be a process, a method, or a manner of manufacture. It could also be a machine, apparatus, or other article. It could also be a substance produced by manufacture. So anything coming under this can be termed as an invention. If you want to make an innovation, not only that you have an idea, you have made it work, it has been made liked by the people. In many applications, it is better if we can proceed in a systematic manner. At the grassroots level, when they are doing it, they may not be to that extent systematic. But those who are working in the technological field, or those who are associated with engineering and technology, those who have undergone a formal education in that, have to proceed in a systematic manner. Which means the innovation have to be systematized under different heads. The first one asset is problem formulation. You need to identify a problem, and that problem should be properly formulated. Second one is problem analysis. You need to analyze it. When you analyze it, one, it should be for safety. Anything innovation that we make should be safe to all human beings, to all life forms, and also to the nature. It should have ease in operation. It should not require us to put in more effort. It should be cost-wise, it should be less. Energy requirement should be less. It should be from the, and they appear also. Some people like some colors, some others like other colors. So you have to take into account the appeal that it should be there for the product that is innovated. And then should also meet the requirement of sales. Because we are creating something, it should be made available to more number of people. If more number of people have to use it, then it has to be marketed. So these are some of the requirements or some of the parameters or factors that should be taken into consideration when you are analyzing the problems been formulated in the first step. The third step in this would be suggesting of a number of solutions. A number of solutions are available as such. So you scan those solutions, select some of them, and see whether that can be applied. The fourth step would be evaluation of all the alternatives in detail and selection of a solution. Presentation is also important. That means documentation has to be carried out for posterity. When we do something, the innovator knows what all things have happened. He has observed it, and he has to retain it or document it for posterity so that others can understand how a particular procedure has taken place, what all difficulties have been faced, how it has been overcome. So all those things, if they are properly documented, others would be able to have information about it so that a repetition of effort may not take place. The last one is production, bringing of the design into regular use. So only if it is produced in large scale that we will be able to give it to more number of people, and they would be able to use it for the purpose. When we are doing things, mostly the machines, apparatus, etc. are created or innovated for doing some work, and therefore it is associated with engineering. In this context, it would be better if we can look at the definition of engineering. It is the arts and science of utilizing the forces and materials of nature for the benefit of mankind and for the direction of man's activities towards his end. So engineering as such is both arts and science, and it also involves utilization of the forces and also the materials of nature. All these are done for the benefit of mankind. And at the same time, science, it's something which is rational and exact. When it is rational and exact, it has to be knowledge ascertained by observation and experiment. It has to be critically tested, systematized, and brought under general principles. So in science, mostly we attempt to draw general principles through observation and experiments, and after critically testing it and systematizing it. Synonymous to engineering is the term your technology. So it is that branch of knowledge which deals with the conversion of raw materials into articles of utility. So raw materials are available, so it's all provided by the nature. This has got to be converted, because raw material as such, we may not be able to utilize it. So if that is to be utilized, certain conversion may have to be brought about. So once that conversion is brought about, we can use it as an article. This requires knowledge about materials. What are the properties of materials? What are kinds of properties of materials are available? All these things should be known to the person who is making an innovation. Then methods must be known. How a particular process can be carried out. Then the tools and equipments which are necessary for doing those methods, that is also important. So he must have knowledge about materials, methods, tools and equipments. When we do innovations, as I said in one of the slides earlier, it has to be manufactured so that it can be put to regular use. So many people invent devices, but only few manage to get their inventions manufactured, which means even though a number of innovations are taking place, only few are getting it manufactured. See here the case of a tool which has been invented. So it's a tool which is a new one, which is, does the work. You can see this is an arachnid husking tool. The person, the operator is husking it, and in the tray you can see the kernel which has been taken out of the nut. But even though it is able to do that work, it's not getting manufactured because it may not be having some of the ingredients that are liked or appreciated by the user. This is another tool which is used for the husking of coconut. This is also a tool which has been invented, and it's also getting manufactured. So between the two, the arachnid husking tool and the coconut, the first one is not getting manufactured in large scale, whereas the second one is getting manufactured in large scale, and therefore the innovation of the coconut husking tool has become more productive. I am trying to take the case of the tool which I have shown just now as to how the development has taken place, how the innovation has taken place. As shown earlier, this is a tool which is for removing the husk of the coconut. Coconut as such has mainly four parts. One is its outer husk. Inside it has a hard shell. And inside, if you open the shell, It will be having a meat, having meat and also having coconut water. And the major operations, suppose you want to make use of the water or the meat that is present, you have to do two operations. And the major operation required would be removal of the husk, that is husking, and the second one is splitting or breaking of the shell. So these two operations are important if you want to retrieve the meat or the coconut water. Husking can be done many ways. There are certain unconventional methods. Some people use fingernails for removing it. It's a very hard process and not everyone can do it. Biting, treading or trampling, stoning, pelting of coconut against stones, trampling by elephants. All these methods are unconventional methods which can be done in very small quantities only, maybe 1, 2 or 3 like that, but not in a large scale. Then we also, in places where coconuts are in abundance, people use conventional tools, which involves a machete. So some people use the machete for removing the husk. Some people use an axe for removing the husk. And the most common one which is used nowadays, earlier, is the crowbar. You have the crowbar fixed on the ground and then the coconut is impaled on the crowbar, twisted, and the husk is removed. Another one that can be done is the pair of tongs. And the last one is a coconut husking tool. This is the figure of a coconut husk removing tool developed in 1946 in the United States. Here the coconut is kept on the ground and the pair of tongs, it is heaved from the top downwards and impaled on the coconut, and then closing the two handles which are apart, you will be able to open it. Doing it 3 or 4 times, one would be able to do the husking. And this has a US patent, so it was patented in 1946. At that time itself, United States had nearly 24 lakhs of patents. Every country is now trying to improve its or enhance its repository of patents, and that is why even India is also encouraging innovations in a very large scale. This is a pair of tongs which is used. It has got long handles. The coconut is, as in earlier case, placed on the ground, and here if it is to be opened, then the handles are made apart, are pulled apart. This is a thing which was reported in 1996. This is a smaller version of that. You are making use of a smaller version of the pair of tongs. And the coconut is again kept on the ground, and depending upon the size, there is a lever which you can see on the left hand side. That lever can be placed on the projections on the one of the handles or the pair of tongs, and then it can be pressed down so that the impaling can be done, and then by separating the handles one would be able to do it, and by doing it 3 or 4 times you will be able to completely remove the husk. And this is another one which was developed in 1995. Here too the thing is kept on the ground, but the tongs which is moved downwards is guided, so that the chances of slippage, in some cases what has happened without these sort of constraints, as you heave it downward, it strikes the coconut and slips off it, and in many cases it has landed on the foot and has injured the foot. So here you are providing a sort of a guide so that it has a fixed track, and thereby it protects or it saves people from getting injured. This is another one that has been developed in 1927 in the United States by R. W. Titmus and R. Hickish. In 1927, as you can see at the bottom of the slide, It carries US patent number 17,24,739. So in 1927, imagine that United States had nearly 70 lakh patents. Here, unlike the earlier ones, it is the tool that is stationary. Tool is kept on the ground, the coconut is impaled from the top, and then by pressing the lever, it has got a pair of blades, and the one blade is stationary, the second one is movable. So as you press the lever downward, the movable jaw or the movable blade moves apart, and that way it rips open the coconut. This is another one. This is developed in Japan. The year is not known. And even though all these things have been made, they have not come into regular use. Maybe because it has its own difficulties. This is another one, again developed in 1998 in the Kerala Agricultural University. Here this is also a foot operated one where both the blades are movable. In the earlier case, what we have seen, one of the blades that is stationary whereas the second one is movable. Here both the blades are movable. So as you press the lever downwards using your foot, both the blades go apart and rips open the coconut. This is the KIU coconut husking tool, which is again a tool that is grounded, that is, it is kept on the ground. The coconut is fed from the top, it is impaled on the two upward turned blades, and after that the lever is pulled upwards and the blades go apart, and thereby the husk is ripped open. And as you take out the coconut from the top, the lever under its own weight will come down and get reset so that the second set of operations can be carried out. This is how it is being used. The second one shows the tool. The first sector of the husk is removed on the top right figure, and the right bottom figure, the second part of the husk is removed. And the last one is removed in the last one, left bottom. So what has started from a pair of tongs, it underwent many changes and modifications. In the first, the coconut rests on the ground, whereas the tool is moved downwards from the top. In the second, which has become a very successful tool and it is in regular use and manufacture, the tool rests on the ground, whereas the coconut is moved downwards from the top. The tool and the coconut just exchanged their positions or roles and see the change in effectiveness. The other one, the first one, was not to that extent effective, or it was not at all accepted by the users. Whereas the second one is widely accepted, it has become very popular, and it is replacing or displacing all other tools which are come into existence for the removal of only for manually operated ones. Its patent was filed on 25/8/1995. Its technology was transferred for large scale manufacture. The university in which it was developed was the Kerala Agricultural University. The Vice Chancellor is handing over the records of the technology to Raidco, which is a company that manufactured it. So it's just a photograph of that. And this is the brochure. You can see on the right hand side the tool. So it has come into regular manufacture. Not only that it is so effective, it is also getting manufactured. So when you make an innovation, the idea should be made to work. In addition to that, it should be made acceptable to the man. That means, in other words, it should be put to regular use. This is another part of the second page of the brochure. And they made it in such a manner that it is split into mainly three pieces, which can be assembled, which can be, that means it is as a knockdown parts and packed, and then it can be marketed. say some statistics with regard to the royalty, etc., that was involved in it. This is the patent document that was received from the patent office. It took nearly 10 years to get the patent at that. That means after filing the patent in 1995, patent was obtained in 2005. So it took nearly 10 years of time. That time, the patent office did not have sufficient number of staff, which means it was getting delayed. So a person who applied for a patent at that time took nearly 6 to 10 years to get the patent. But now it has been eased, it has been made quicker, and in 2 to 4 years time one would be able to get the patent. Because any patent document is a techno-legal document. Not only that, it should convey the technical details, it should also be considered for legal aspects. Unless it is legally protected, one will not be able to derive benefits from that. And this tool also won the NRDC 1999 Republic Day Award for Meritorious Inventions. National Research Development Corporation under the Government of India awarded it with the 1999 Republic Day Award. So here is the story about the Veeramitra, a Cochrane Tasking Tool and Innovation from Kerala, India. So now this tool has gone even to other countries also, like Sri Lanka or the Southeast Asian countries, etc., where Cochrane is being grown in plenty. They are utilizing this tool. So this tool shall continue to coexist with the coconut as long as the husking of coconut manually is a necessity. So here was a necessity. That necessity has been taken care of by the introduction of this tool. When we think about making innovations, as far as possible, one has to make innovations simple. That is very important. Not that every tool can be made simple. So it says as far as possible. So if it is possible, try to make it simple. Make an innovation simple in respect of one, design. In design it should be simple. In shape it should be simple. In construction it should be simple. In use it should be simple. In addition to that, it should be light in weight. It should be light in the effort that should be that is needed to be applied. Should be low in cost and also low in energy use. So these aspects have to be taken care of if you want to make an innovation simple. You look at some of these. The top one, as you can see, is a hairpin. The second one is a paper clip. Third and fourth also, they are paper clips. Look at the shape. What is it? Ultimately, if you look at it, this has come from a simple piece of wire. So a wire has been modified or deformed to such an extent that it can find different use. So the first one, it has been simply provided a curve. It has been made in the shape of U. So it can be used on the to do the hair of women. So it's nothing but a hairpin. See the number that is in use. It is countless. Billions and billions of hairpins must have been used by this time, ever since its innovation. Look at the paper clip. This also is in use in large number. Billions could be in use. And different shapes are provided. The second one is a bear, the third one is a bear clip that is having almost a triangular shape. The other two, they are coated. One is painted, the other one is provided with a tubular cover. This is another one. This is simply a handle of a vessel made out of stainless steel. This is again made out of a piece of wire. What has been done? It has been provided with the two curls on either side. So it can be used for lifting bucket or any other vessel as the case may be. How simple it is. But see the number that is in use. It's very easy to make also. So that is one aspect about it. As you can see, is a keychain. It's again made out of a piece of wire. It has been provided a few turns. And the coils are placed very closely so that very safely you can carry a key. If it is simply a ring without any coil, it may open up and there are chances for the key to be lost. Whereas in this case, once it is put within the key, it's not very easy to get out of that. So it is safe. And how simple it is. It's also made out of a piece of wire, simply provided two bends, and as a result, it has been formed in the shape of a ring, and it is serving the purpose. And how many people are using it? Again, a piece of wire. It has been bent to form a hanger. So you can hang a piece of shirt or a pair of pants on it. How simple it is. And you can imagine, it's very difficult to imagine the number of hangers that are used. This is a pair of a torsion spring. Unlike the other ones, here it has got the resilience. So it can be used for opening something and closing it in an angular manner because it is a torsional spring. So even though this is also made out of a piece of wire, but it has been provided of a sort of a bend such that it can be utilized as a torsional spring. This is another form of spring. One a compressive one and the other one a tensile spring. You can see one can be extended, the other one can be shortened. Again, made out of pieces of wires. Simply it has been coiled and they are assembled in such a manner that one can act as a tension spring and the other one can act as a compression spring. And they serve purposes or serve different purposes. And here too, if you look at it, a number of them are in use. Again, it is countless, maybe in different sizes. Again, made out of a piece of wire. All that has been done is to provide a hole on one end and the other end is sharpened. Two of them are provided, one for stitching sacks, etc. Therefore, it has got a larger diameter, which is longer, and even the hole that is there, that is bigger. And the second one is known as wall. It's generally used for stitching clothes. It's smaller in size. So if you look at the articles or two innovations, they are resembling the same, but they find different types of uses. And the manufacturing of course is not to that extent easier. Articles made out of piece of wire, a nail, different types of nails are available, and the bottom two are basically pins, paper pins. Almost has the resemblance of the nail. This is the one which is used in the internal combustion engines for controlling the valve, for controlling the inlet and or inflow outflow of the gases. So this is a proper tool which is commonly used in engines. Again, it has been made out of a piece of rod and one has been upset whereas the other one has been slightly machined to give some sort of a form so that it can be. Here also, this is too many of them are in use. Again, out of a wire, it's a poker, which it can be used for making a hole. Again, made out of a piece of wire or a rod, at the same time, it can provide the rod with a hand. And the left-hand side, it is nothing but a screwdriver. So it can be used for driving in or driving out the screws when you are making points. Screws. Again, produced by wires, all simple and can you count the number that are used in Kerala? That's like change the form of the raw material that is used. It is a plate. It is used to make it's used as a handle for operating or doors, wires, etc. This can be used. So it's a piece of a flat piece of steel. It's got four holes. So sort of bend has been provided so you can insert your finger and then pull the door at it. This one is a drawing board clip used for fixing, holding paper on wooden planks or on drawing board. It's also made out of flat pieces of metal. It has a certain amount of resilience so that it can have the function of a holder. Here made up of flat pieces. The blade which is there for the saw, it's a flat piece of metal. Knife has a flat piece of metal. Chisel, that's a flat piece of metal. And blade is also vertically thin, all the difference. And here the pencil cutter, blade which is again slightly thicker. It's also made out of a piece of flat piece. Now two of them are joined together here. Pieces joined together with a pivot so that you can use for sharing articles. Pair of scissors. Again, almost the same form but used for a different purpose, for holding something. Another tool which is used in surgical procedures. Again, another one that also for holding, but the operation principle is different. Or sheet notes, different purposes. So all these articles of innovations, so make an innovation simple. They we made simple in design, shape, construction, use. You should be light in weight, to be applied, to be low cost, and also energy use. So I would request all of you to be innovators or innovators and serve the humanity and national interest.